Let's get more reaction on Metro Manila's quarantine from the business community. We now have on the line George Barcelon, the President Emeritus of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Good to have you back, George. Welcome to the program.
Morning, Kathy.
All right. So what do you make of the President's announcement of a community quarantine in Metro Manila? How will it affect business?
Well, first of all, we're very supportive of the statements of the President. You can see his sincerity in protecting the Filipino citizens from this virus. We get a broad picture of what this quarantine would mean, but there are areas that need clarification.
Such as? Which kind of clarification are you looking
as,
for?
Well, such as the restriction of land, air, and sea transport to Metro Manila. Some of this has been aired when Secretary Anyo and also Secretary Mon Lopez has stated that cargoes in and out of Metro Manila would not be a problem. The other issue as far as the manpower and the workers coming from outside of Metro Manila and vice versa, I mean, would require certain ID checking and everything. This may be a bit tough on implementing. So we seek clarification on that matter.
Why would it be tough, George? And what sort of recommendations would you have to the government concern?
I would think that nowadays most of the business community, they have their own way of checking. Well, of course, it's a very superficial check on whether somebody has fever or not. Okay? That's an indicator. Upon entering any premise now, you're being checked. So I would think that if somebody's coming outside of Metro Manila, of course, they must be coming in for some reasons, either work or delivery or whatnot. And the precaution is already taken by the private sector on that. If there's going to be a lot of checkpoints, I would think that some of this may be undue delay. But we're still waiting for the IRR and how this is to be implemented. The interagency task force will, I'm sure, come out and collaborate with the private sectors on what is the best way to implement this.
All right. Well, do keep us up to speed on the developments as the task force is set to meet this afternoon at 1 p.m. local. Thank you so much for joining us, George Barcelon.
Thanks, Kathy.